My name is Kate Poropatich. I am a third year resident in anatomic pathology here at Northwestern. I am starting a research fellowship in tumor immunology. I am having the time of my life right now, being able to do both the clinical training and work in the laboratory. I really like being able to go into lab and not know what I'm expecting each day. It is frustrating when experiments don't work, but it's really amazing when you find something that does work and you're repeating it and you find that it's really a pattern that holds true. I grew up in a household with a father who's an Army doc. It had a big impact on my growing up and wanting to go into medicine. I always thought I was going to be practicing as a doctor or serving in countries abroad. I did not always know that I wanted to do research. It really wasn't until I did a master's program in immunology that I learned, wow, I really like this a lot, and it's sort of getting me to think about things I've never thought about before. So I went to medical school at George Washington University. When I completed medical school, I came here to Chicago. What makes Northwestern a good fit for me is knowing that I'm on a defined path of being a physician scientist. It can be a little bit ambiguous when you start residency because you get so caught up in the clinical training. But what's so great about being here in this program is that you have these reminders and the sort of integration of the physician scientist training program throughout your residency.
So I have this slide here for a patient that had head and neck cancer.
Tumor immunology is studying the way in which the host's immune system is able to fight foreign antigens. This is becoming a very exciting area of research. The ultimate question that I want to answer is why, first of all, are we seeing a rising number of patients present with HPV-driven throat cancer? And why do these patients seem to be more responsive than other patients to therapy? Is it that they have immune cells that are different than other types of cancers? I think they serve as a great model for learning about host immune system and how we can take those lessons to other tumors that are more aggressive and might not have the same sort of immune response. We definitely need more physician scientists. What physician scientists can offer that other researchers can't is questions that are really geared towards the clinic. You're thinking about questions that will benefit your patients and how you can better impact their outcome. I am very optimistic about women wanting to be physician scientists because I don't think there has been a better time for us to be entering that type of career path. There's no reason we can't do it, and there's nothing holding us back.